second. Virgin Islands, down in the Caribbean.
Panama?
And, no, I guess Cancun, Mexico is as close as I could be.
Saved the whole world out.
Looks like Costa Rica.
Esperamos tenerlo en Costa Rica. La segunda hora.
Está muy bien organizado.
There comes the third wave, huh?
Está Canal 13.
Es el grupo de Costa Rica.
This is your press.
The third wave.
Shaking hands.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I am delighted to welcome President Mulcahy of Costa Rica. Costa Rica is an old and valued friend of the United States. Its dramatic tradition has made that country a natural partner of the United States in the Caribbean and, in fact, in the whole hemisphere. Our meeting is in keeping with my policy of working very closely with our Democratic friends in this hemisphere, and I most appreciated the President's views on his country's prospects and problems. I personally pledged my administration's support for Costa Rica's efforts at economic recovery. And I'm also deeply appreciative of the President's strong support for the Caribbean Basin Initiative, and understand that he's going to make that support known to our Congress. We discussed the prospects for democracy in the region. We noted that fair and free elections have been held this year in his own country, Costa Rica, and Colombia, where they've long been a tradition, and Honduras, El Salvador, and the Dominican Republic as well. We've also discussed the threat to this welcome development by forces of the extreme right and the extreme left, the latter aided and abetted by Nicaragua and Cuba. We candidly assessed the inter-American system in light of the recent conflict in the South Atlantic. We agreed that the system and its ability to respond to threats to the peace must be strengthened, and this required our urgent attention. And finally, let me say again, it's been my great pleasure in meeting and talking with you, Mr. President. I look forward to our working together in the common problems that face us in this hemisphere. And it's a pleasure to welcome you to America.
Muchas gracias, Presidente. Muchas gracias. He agradecido profundamente al presidente Reagan esta invitación para venir a representar al gobierno y al pueblo de Costa Rica.
I have expressed my deep appreciation to President Reagan for this invitation to come here in representation of the government and the people of Costa Rica.
Destaqué en mis palabras de agradecimiento que fue una extrema muestra de simpatía y de apoyo a la democracia costarricense el hecho de que la invitación se me envió el propio día que yo asumía funciones de gobierno, el último 8 de mayo.
And I pointed out in my words of appreciation to the president that this was a great indication of the sympathy and the support for Costa Rican democracy, that is the fact that this invitation was extended to me the very day that I took office this past May 8th.
He tenido el privilegio de venir a reiterar y a ratificar una alianza de toda la vida de nuestra patria con los Estados Unidos de Norteamérica.
It has been my privilege to come here to reiterate and to ratify an alliance that has existed from the very early days of our country with the United States of America.
Una pequeña democracia sin ejército ha sido de siempre sincera aliada de la gran potencia que son los Estados Unidos de Norteamérica, porque hemos estado siempre identificados con los ideales y las concepciones de la libertad y de la justicia en favor de los pueblos de la tierra.
And so this small democracy without an army has always been a sincere ally of this great power called the United States of America, because we have always identified with the ideals and the conceptions of freedom of justice and good for the good of all of the peoples throughout the earth.
Esa alianza fue siempre muy importante para nuestros países, pero es ahora de dramática trascendencia. Nunca estuvo más acorralada la democracia por las extremas del pensamiento político como lo está en estos momentos.
And so this alliance has become a matter of great importance for our countries throughout the past, but never more than now in this dramatic occasion. Its importance is of really dramatic significance, because we are caught in a pincer now, that is the democratic forces, between the extremes of political thinking now more than ever before.
He traído al presidente Reagan el relato crudo de nuestra situación difícil en el campo económico y social, y la información fidedigna de que sí estamos bajo una ofensiva muy grande del totalitarismo marxista-leninista en el área centroamericana y del Caribe.
I have conveyed to President Reagan the harsh realities of our present economic and social crisis and the true information as to the fact that there is indeed a massive offensive on the part of totalitarian Marxism-Leninism in the area of Central America and the Caribbean.
Le he repetido al presidente Reagan que necesitamos solidaridad y ayuda para superar los problemas económicos y los desajustes sociales por los que atravesamos, para de esa manera preservar en paz la base democrática que representa Costa Rica.
I have repeated to President Reagan our need for solidarity and for assistance in order to enable us to overcome these economic difficulties and social problems that we are undergoing at the present time, and in order to preserve peace, in peace, this democratic base, which is Costa Rica.
He confirmado la profunda convicción que nos anima en cuanto a que para defender la democracia, la mejor herramienta es la lucha incesante contra la pobreza, por la justicia social, por el crecimiento económico. Creo que por duras y difíciles que sean las circunstancias por las que atravesamos, y así se lo he manifestado al presidente Reagan, soy optimista. Al final de la jornada seguirán teniendo validez en la conciencia de nuestros pueblos los ideales comunes de libertad, de justicia y de paz que defienden desde siempre los pueblos de los Estados Unidos y el pueblo de Costa Rica.
And so I confirm that in order to defend democracy, this is something that is one of my deep convictions, that in order to defend democracy, the best tool we have in this unceasing struggle is an unceasing struggle against poverty, a struggle in favor of social justice, a struggle for economic growth. And I believe that no matter how harsh or difficult the circumstances may be, that we, as I told President Reagan, feel optimistic. And I think that at the end of the day, that the validity of these concepts in the conscience of our people will be intact. That is, these shared ideals of freedom, of justice, and of peace that have always been defended by the people of the United States and the people of Costa Rica.
Muchas gracias al presidente Reagan por haber aceptado la ratificación de esta alianza de la pequeña Costa Rica con los poderosos Estados Unidos para seguir luchando por la libertad y por la justicia en favor de nuestros pueblos.
And thank you very much, President Reagan, for having accepted my ratification of this alliance between tiny Costa Rica and the powerful United States for the continuation of the struggle for freedom and justice for the good of our peoples.
Justice was done, sir.